everyone, and welcome to my channel. I am Make It Up Supergirl. Today I'm super excited to share with you my Eyescream Beauty Bag for December 2023, and I'll show you how I came up with this makeup look. So if this interests you, please keep watching, and don't forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to tickle that cute little bell down below to be notified of all my new content. All right, let's get started. So the first item I want to share with you is an eyeshadow palette, and this has a manufacturer price of $35. So let me show you how pretty it is. And that's the beautiful palette right there. Isn't that beautiful? So the second item in this bag is a face powder, and this has a manufacturer price of $25. And let me show you how beautiful the packaging is. That is the outside. I think that's really, really beautiful. And that is what it looks like. That is so beautiful. The last item is called the Gold Opal Eyeshadow, and this has a manufacturer price of $30. So let me show you what the packaging looks like. And that is what it looks like. Isn't that pretty? And that is what it looks like. Isn't that beautiful? That is gorgeous. Well, that concludes everything that was in my Eyescream Beauty Bag. I received 3 items and it had a value of $90. And if you're interested in seeing how I came up with this makeup look, I'll be right back. Now that I have the camera up and close, I'm going to go ahead and start my makeup look. And I'm going to use the lightest shade in this palette. And I'm going to use that as a base shade. And I'm going to put that all over my eyelid. So I'm going to go ahead and start putting it on. And right away, I can tell this is very, very pigmented. Just gonna pat that on. And I'm using a flat brush to apply it. And I am pressing the shadow into my eyelid. So I am really impressed with the shadow so far. Just gonna put that all over. But that looks pretty good. I'm really impressed with this eyeshadow already, and this is just the first shade. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other eye. Put that all over my eyelid. Really getting that color on there. And this is very pigmented. I've never heard of this brand before, but wow, very impressed. Sometimes I don't always start with the base shade, but since I want to try a good number of the colors in this palette, I want to try it. So that is going on very, very well. I really think that shade did a great job laying down the base of my eyelid. And now I'm going to use kind of like the medium tone brown. And I'm going to put that right here in my upper crease. So let me go ahead and get started. I'm going to take a little fluffy brush. And I'm going to kind of gently go in my crease. And just kind of buff that in there. It almost matches my eyelid color. But I might add a little bit darker color in there, but it's going on really, really nicely. All right, I'm just gonna kind of build both sides here. How do you guys do your makeup? Do you do one side and then you do the other one? Or do you do one completely done and then switch to the other one? And I'm sure you're surprised that I'm actually using more neutral tones, but lately I've been getting more into the more neutral colors, and you know what? They're just as pretty as the bright colors. The bright colors are a lot of fun though. I think this palette's gonna be a great palette for me to use for work. So I do notice that this is buildable, so you can just kind of pack on more color as you need. All right, since that color is just a little too light for me, I'm gonna actually use the color that almost looks like a dark gray, but I'm not quite sure what the color is, but I'm gonna go ahead and use that, and I'm gonna put a little bit of that in my upper crease. So So I'm just gonna kind of stamp it in a little bit. I just love Eyescream Beauty, not only because their subscription is affordable, but I love it that they introduce you to new brands that you've never tried before. And yeah, that color looks much better. The other one just seemed to like blend into my eyelid and I couldn't really see it. But I can definitely see that a lot better. I'm gonna build that up. Just wanna get right there underneath my brow bone. There we go, I can start seeing some color now. And I've said in previous videos, the reason why I choose to go in my upper crease is because, as you can see, I have a fold here. So my eyes are hooded. So if I put anything right here in the crease and I open my eyes, you're not gonna see anything. So that's why I move everything up. And that's kind of like a trick that people use so that you can see the shadow. And I love playing with all kinds of shadows. Well, I really like how that accentuated my upper crease. And now I'm gonna go ahead and use the darkest shade in the palette, and I'm gonna use that to darken the outer corner of my eyelid. So I'm just gonna tap my brush, and then I'm gonna kind of stamp in the outer corner and kind of build up my pigment. So as you can see, I'm using the front of my brush, and then I'm kind of like tapping it on the side. I want to build up that color. And when you build up the outer corner with the darker shade, it provides a little bit more depth of your makeup look. And I prefer that. So I'm just going to keep on building that because I want to see it. And then I'm going to lightly brush in, and I'm gonna go probably about a quarter of the way in of my eyelid. I almost think this is kind of like a dark brown, but I can't really tell. But I'm really liking it because this is gonna create a very pretty look. It looks like it's very buildable, so I'm just gonna keep on going. And I love my eye shields because they help me as a guide a little bit too. And then I'm gonna take that color and just kind of brush it where my lash line is, just a little bit. Alright, I think I did a really good job darkening this eye. I'm gonna go ahead and do this one. Well, I think this did a really good job darkening the outer corners of my eyelids. I think I did a really good job darkening my corners, and now I'm gonna use a shimmer shade, and I'm gonna use that, and I'm gonna put it from my inner corner till about right there, so I can't wait to try this. Dip it in there, and ooh, whoa! That is really, really pretty. That is so beautiful. And it is very pigmented. I really like that. Just gonna use that to pat on my eyelid. This is really, really rich and creamy. This is beautiful. That is so, so pretty. That is really, really beautiful. And now I'm gonna take a little bit of a small flat brush, and I'm gonna put some of that and put it right here in my inner corner. I'm having a hard time reaching that. I'm just gonna take a little bit of my brush and kind of pat right there. This is just such a beautiful color. do the other side. I think that turned out really, really beautiful. And now I'm gonna use an angle brush and I'm gonna use that first shade again. And I'm gonna use that just to go underneath my eyebrow bone, just to highlight it a little bit. I'm just gonna take my brush and lightly tap in the shadow. And then I'm just gonna kinda put that right under my eyebrow. Just to highlight it a little bit. Alright, I think I'm at a really good stopping point with my makeup look. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and finish the rest of my makeup and I'll be right back. Well, this is my final look. I think it turned out absolutely beautiful and I really enjoyed using this palette. And thank you so much for taking the time to watch my video. I really appreciate it. And please remember to love yourself, love others, know that you're loved, and that we're all beautiful. Have a great day, everyone. Bye.